Hi guys, welcome back. Thank you so much for being here. So in today's video, we're going to be talking all about newest Pat McGrath quad. She released three of them for her holidays, and this was the one that caught my eye. So I'm gonna be creating these two eye makeup looks. We're gonna be talking all about formula in here, why there was a price drop in these quad, and yeah, we're gonna be playing with this little guy. If that sounds fun to you and this is the first time here, my name is Gigi. Thanks so much for clicking on my channel. I hope you stay subscribed for more. Click that red button below and also come over to my Instagram, because over there we do a lot of fun things. I keep you posted on makeup releases, makeup sales, and we do get to talk and interact quite a bit, so it is very fun. So come over and follow me over there, and without further ado, let's start. Alrighty, friends, so as I mentioned, this was the one that caught my eye. It really caught my attention because of this blue in the quad. The other ones, there was a pastel one kind of looking, I'll post a picture. That one, it just looked really springy to me, not really holiday, so I just kept on it. I didn't even look at it. And then the other one, it had that pink in it, that if you know Pat, just keep giving us so much pink, and I don't know, I just got nauseous just from looking at that quad. I'm going to be honest, I needed to skip on it, but this one you guys looked stunning. And unfortunately, mine is shattered to pieces, so it came very, very broken, and I am so sad. I ordered this one from Sephora because I didn't want to wait for Pat's shipping. So this is Pat McGrath Celestial Divinity Luxe Quad. I picked up mine from Sephora. It retails for $77 Canadian, and this one is in the shade Interstellar Icon. It is described as a colorful collection of four glitter and shimmer shades that delivers a show-stopping glamour to eyes. Teleport eyes to glamorous new galaxies with the Interstellar Icon palette, staring at electric turquoise, golden champagne, deep shimmering burgundy, and rich golden rose. The Interstellar Icon has golden polaris, which is a luminous rose gold. It has divine dahlia, iridescent bronze taupe, hypnotic lilac luster, and blue blood burgundy. As you just saw from the swatches, you guys, these shades are absolutely stunning. They're extremely pigmented. They're a one swipe kind of shades. They are just very pretty. I find the color story and the combinations of all these shadows to be particularly special for the holidays. Is everything. I love the two eye looks I came up with. I found that these kind of shades are very easy to do a one, you know, one shadow kind of eye, and then lashes and liner, and you're good to go. These are very, very pretty. We're gonna move on to the demo portion application of this video, and then I'm gonna come back for final thoughts. Alrighty, friends, so let's start playing. And I am so heartbroken. My beautiful shadow here came shattered to pieces. I tried to, you know, press it back in, and then it came into my blue. It was a mess. I had to scrape it off the blue, and oh man. So I am very, very sad, but we're going to make it work. I do wanna just dip into the blue right away. That's why I bought this palette, because of this blue. So what I'm going to do is just take it on a Builder Pro, and I am going to press. Actually, I have to either wet this brush so I don't make a mess, or yeah, I didn't apply base, so I just wet it. And these shadows are usually really, really just because they're really glittery, they could make a big mess. So be aware, all my base is done and I don't want to make a mess. And look at this stunning shade. This is the reason why this palette called my name, just because of this blue. I thought it was unique to my collection. And these duochrome shades from her, the beauty of them is that you can just leave it like this. Do wing, liner, mascara, and you can color the day. But we are going to dip into her darker shade just a little bit. Let me actually find tiny brush. So I am going to dip into the darkest, and I am going to apply it in my outer V just to deepen out my outer V. Ooh, that was pigmented. I picked up a little bit of it. I don't want to make this a very super dramatic. I just want to leave it the blue to be the center of attention. Oh, and this purple shade is pretty. Look at that. It was really, really easy to blend. So I'm gonna bring whatever is left in my brush like this. And I'm just blending with no shadows. Just blending a little bit higher. And that's it, friends. Very simple. This is all I wanna do. Really, I wanted this blue to be everything. I love it. I love it. Look at that. Other eye, I did wanted to use, of course, the lighter shade. But this shade is just crumbling all over the place. So I am going to wet my brush and pick up that shade and apply it all over my lid. Oh, look at that. This is precious. And the consistency of this shadow is like you're working with a cream shadow. It's so, so soft. And this is so, so pretty. And I'm going to take, maybe I'll take the other sort of like green for my outer V, just to deepen this one out as well. And that green to me looks like a one shadow kind of thing. It looks very, very pretty on the pen. So I am going to just concentrate it here. Friends, and I don't know if the camera will ever do a justice on these ones. These are stunning. I do feel like I wanna put, oh man. I do feel like I want to put the blue. I'm gonna pack the blue on this lower lash as a pop of color. I'm going to get this wet. That is so pretty. And then for this one, I'm just gonna take the purple that we used. Like so, and then for my inner corners, I am going to apply just a lighter shade in both. And I picked up a lot of product because this is just crumblier than usual, right? Because it broke. It picks up a lot. All right, oh my goodness, this is so, so precious. Let me just finish off the rest of my face, liner, mascara, and then I'll be right back. Alrighty friends, so as I show you my two makeup looks, extremely easy, so easy to do, very pigmented, very easy to work with. This palette is just very pretty, 100% worth every single penny. And speaking of penny, I did want to talk about the formula change in this palette. So she's giving us a new formula, but that you're going to find that formula is a creamy matte formula, and you're gonna find in the pink shade in the other one, in the rose palette, not here. Here she's not giving us any new formulation, but she did added some, you know, more matte kind of formulas, not like bleeds or astral shades. So for example, this is last year's, this is in the shade Ritualistic Rose. So this is her holiday palette last year. It is a different, the back of it, I wanted to point out, so they do look identical, but at the back, this is last year, so it looks very luxe, a lot more than this. But she's giving us the names in here, the names of the shadows, and you're not fighting with this paper in here. So, you know, give it or take. I think this is better because I hated that paper. I much rather have this golden back because it's much more luxe, but I mean, it's okay. Now, here I wanted to say that this one, she usually, last year, she gave us only like the astrals, the blitz, they're really glittery kind of shadows. So there are people that, oh, I swatched the same shadow twice. Wow, way to go, Angie. So sorry for the crooked swatches, you guys, but this is last year's quad. And in here, you get all her special formulas, you know, the pricey ones. And these were more expensive than this year's. So there was a change in, you know, the shadows that she placed on her quads. This year, she decided to go with more, a different approach, using, oh my God, I'm so scared to open. Like something like this, which is, you know, a really pigmented shade, you can see it, but it leans more creamy, matte, satin, maybe satin, not really matte, but it's not a blitz. So what I'm trying to get at here is that I think she did that so that people have the option to really, you know, work with something else than glitter. And to me, this was much better than this one. When I grab the older palette, all I can do is glitter. So I tend to use this as a one shadow look and then reach for something else to my outer V. This palette, I'm very content with this both look. So in my opinion, this was a very, very nice. I love the quad. I'm obsessed with this blue. I find it so pretty. This shade here is a very, very pretty, you guys. I don't think the camera is gonna do a justice on how reflective, how duochrome, how pretty it is. And you can use this one as a highlighter totally. I didn't do that because this is really crumbly, so I was going to make a mess. I'm using her highlighter today, which I try to make it, you know, a little bit more natural. I didn't want to be to boom on your face. If you want to see a review on this, I'm gonna link it above. I did some comparison swatches with her newest highlighter, but yeah, this is the quad. I am very, very happy with it. I think it's precious for the holidays, and yeah, you guys, I think it's 100% worth the money. I know it is a pricey quad, but I think it's worth every single penny. The formulas in there are worth it, and yeah, you guys, I really, really enjoyed working with it. Alrighty friends, and that was it. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know in the comments, what do you think of this quad? Did you like it? Are you thinking about it? What do you think of my two makeup looks? What do you think of her price drop, her placement of the shadows, the back of it, everything that I talked about? What do you think? Let me know. Drop me a comment. Thanks so much, you guys, for love and support. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.